In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you, we praise you, we bless you, and we love you. Thank you, Lord, for this abundance of grace, blessing you always bestow on us. Thank you, Lord, that as we come to know about your word more and more, you open our eyes, our minds, and our senses and our hearts to receive your word. Thank you, Holy Spirit of God, for taking over and bringing to our knowledge, bringing to our wisdom, bringing to our understanding everything that we need to know from the word of God to make our life victorious as each day passes. Lord, you said, seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and everything has been added unto us. So yes, Lord, here we are to seek you every day, to learn you every day, to know about you every day, and to just apply all that you teach us every day. This we ask in the mighty and glorious name of Jesus, and all God's people said, Amen. Amen and amen. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Yeah. Today, I would like to speak about, I want to speak upon some things like two extremes. Like once I had given a teaching on two extremes, that is a mountain and the mustard seed. Today, the same struck me and I said, let me teach about two things in the kingdom of God, that is blessing and curse. Okay, so let's go into what is blessing, what is curse, and you know, only we can be affected by these two, nothing more than this. The Bible is, if you are rooted in the word of God, you are blessed. If you are not rooted in the word of God, it's not that you are cursed, but you don't know you are blessed. You don't know you are blessed. So, and when you don't know you are blessed, you call yourself cursed. Okay? So that is the major difference what happens when we do not know the word of God. So let's learn about it and let's see what the Lord has to tell us about it. Yeah? Okay. So now, if we speak about blessings, let us look what is blessings. I have already must have told this earlier also, but let's look once again. It's always good to go back, see for ourselves, revise, and you know, be firm about it so that we do not forget. And tomorrow when we speak to anyone, we are very clear on that. Okay, so yes, so Genesis 1:28. Let's see if I can do something. Yeah, I put on screen. Okay. So, yeah, thank you, Sister Sylvia. Even she put on chat. So Genesis 1:28. Blessings. What are blessings? So, and God blessed them. And God said unto them, be fruitful and multiply and replenish the earth and subdue it and have dominion over the fish of the sea and the fowl of the air and over every living thing that moves upon the earth. Now, if we see that this is blessing, then what is not blessing? What is curse? Curse is, do not be fruitful and you will not multiply. You will not replenish the world. You cannot subdue the earth and you cannot have dominion over anything. You lose your dominion over everything if you are in curse. When you do not have the knowledge that you are blessed. Okay? It is like you are not in curse. It's not curse. We are not in curse. But we do not know the knowledge. We do not have the wisdom. We do not have the knowledge that we are blessed. And now when we come to the word, when we come to the truth of the gospel, now we know what is blessed. Okay? So blessing is being fruitful, being multiplied. So the Lord has already blessed us with this fruitfulness, with this multiplication. So whatever we do of our hands, whatever work we do of our hands, we multiply. If somebody has a business is only like maybe one center now, but we can always multiply. We have branches of that in future. So we are multiplying. Okay. If there is human race, humankind, what is happening? We are multiplying. Every day there is a newborn baby in this world. We are multiplying. So the Lord has brought us to multiply. Each and every one has given, even the plants, the animals, they are multiplying, right? So God has put a seed to multiply in everyone. Okay? But God has given us a special power, a special authority. And that is, we have the dominion over everything. And why do we have the dominion? We have the dominion because God has made us in his likeness and image. Because we have been made in the likeness and image of our Lord, now we have the dominion over everything. So God created man in his own image. Okay? So let us understand this. So this is the blessings what we have. Now, what is curse? Let us see today the Bible, if it teaches us on curse also. Let's see that, okay? What is curse? Till now we have seen only blessings, na? Is my screen visible?
No, sister.
Yes.
No.
No. So, okay, fine. Is my screen visible now?
Yes.
Okay. See. Listen. From verse number 15, Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse number 15. But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken to the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe all the commandments and the statutes which I command this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee. Okay? Cursed shall be thou in the city, and cursed shall be thou in the field. Curse shall be in the basket, means everything. These are all the curses. And know that even curses are written in the Bible just as blessings are written. Okay? But there is something that has overtaken that curse. And that is right? This particular verse of the Bible has overtaken that curse of us. We are not under any curse of the law, because whatever was there in the Old Testament has been washed by the precious blood of Jesus. It is no more there upon us. So the Bible teaches us about blessings and the Bible teaches us about cursing. Okay. Now tell me one thing. Okay, we have seen this. Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law. For Jesus himself became a curse for us. For curse is every person that hangs on a tree. Okay, and verse number 14 says that we are filled with Abraham's blessings also. So Jesus has given us the blessings of Abraham. So we are no more under any curse. Once we have the knowledge of the word of God, we no more consider ourselves under any curse. But now tell me one thing. I need you all to answer me. Do we yet are under curse? Do we feel our life under curse?
No.
Do we put ourselves under curse?
No, sister.
No.
No, we don't put Sometimes when we speak something what is going against the word of God, do we put ourselves under curse?
Yes.
We do, sir. Yes. We are not perfect. So sometimes
look
we
at
do.
This, Proverbs 18:21. What does it say? Death and life are in the power of your tongue. So when we speak something wrong, when we speak something which is not according to the word of God, now that is that death, that is that curse which we unknowingly put upon ourselves. If we say, my life is a mess, I don't know why did I get born, I don't know why this family, I don't know why this husband, I don't know why this office, I'm not getting job, I'm having so much of financial difficulty, I'm in so much of mess, I don't know when I will get, when I will just get rid of all this. Now, everything of this, whatever I am saying, is a curse. Means the Lord is not come to give us a curse. The Lord has come to take away our curse. But when we operate by Proverbs 18:21, and now we speak death over our life, even when Jesus has given us life, now that is a curse. So we need to be so very careful when we speak about ourselves, when we speak anything from our mouths. And that is exactly what activates curse and what activates blessings. That is exactly what we have to learn from our knowledge, from the knowledge that God has given us. Okay? Now, when we know that we have the blessings of the Lord, this is our knowledge. We have gained the knowledge. Genesis 1, 26 and 27, we just saw that we are made in the likeness and image. And in Genesis 1:28, we see our blessings, that we are called to be fruitful, we are called to be multiplied. Okay, and we also seen Galatians 1:3-13 saying that Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law. Okay, so now some people say, what if somebody else, some of them, like even after knowing that we are not under any curse, but some people, when they are not rooted in the word, what happens to their spirit? They have a weak spirit when they're not rooted in the word. So when you come across some people like that, okay, there is one more scripture which we can show them. But that is also on the faith, on the belief. One minute. Can we see this? Genesis chapter 12, verses 1 to 3. Now the Lord said to Abraham, get thee out of thy country and from thy kindred and from thy father's house unto a land. Now this is what the Lord is speaking to Abraham. And I will make thee a great nation, and I will bless thee and make thy name great, and thou shalt be a blessing. Thou shalt be a blessing. Now, and I will bless them that bless thee, and curse them that curse thee. And in thee shall all the families of the earth be blessed. Now, there are some people who say, even after being in the word, they will say that my relative or my friend or somebody, they curse me. They say things against me. They say that I'm a black sheep of the family. I'm not worthy of the family. I bring lack in the family. Okay? So they will always say, no, it's like, I'm always getting cursed. But if that person believes in the word of God, okay, totally, we don't even have to actually show the scripture. This is just to show us that how much God loves us. How much God loves us. Because if that person believes in the word of God and believes in what the Lord has done for her or him on the cross, now that person believes that Christ has taken the curse on the cross. Okay? Whatever curse whoever gets, that is on the cross. Now, we've seen many people who do not get pregnant, okay? We see that always they, not they, but the people around them, they will always say something. And, you know, the society, the world will say something against them. But when those people come, know the truth now, and now they take this particular scripture and they say, no, Christ has redeemed me from the curse of the law. Because Jesus himself became a curse for me on the cross and filled me with Abraham's blessings. Now, why do we say filled me with Abraham's blessings? Because Abraham was the one who got the inheritance, who got the blessings of the generations. He was the one. And therefore, when we come under Abraham, now we have the same blessings that Abraham carries. Okay, so let us understand one thing. Everything, every good thing of our life and every bad thing of our life lies in our tongue. What comes out of our tongue is more important. Okay, now when my spirit is strong, it is like my immune system. When my spirit is strong, whatever comes against me, I will never get weak. And I will take up that challenge very strongly, very firmly in the Lord, because now I am fighting that spiritual battle in the Lord. Okay? What does Hosea 4:6 says? Hosea 4:6 says, my people are destroyed due to lack of knowledge. Nowhere it is said that my people are destroyed because of the devil. It is said that it is destroyed. We are destroyed due to lack of knowledge. Now, once we understand what the Lord talks about us, once we understand the truth of the gospel, so we ourselves will never come under any type of torment, torture, even if the devil, even if the enemy has to speak in our minds. Now, what is a curse? A definition of curse, okay? A curse is a force. When it is activated, it destroys anything and everything that God has given you. Curse is a force. Where is that force activated? That force is activated in the mind. That force, it's known as a force because it pressurizes your mind. It pressurizes your mind in such a way that now you have to speak destruction. And now when you speak destruction, now that is the time when you are activating the law from your mouth, which brings destruction in your life. So curse is a force. When it is activated, it will destroy anything and everything that God has given you. Okay? What did God give us? God gave us blessings, because we are not acknowledging blessings. So what we are doing, we are taking that curse into consideration, that pressure into consideration, and now we are opening our mouth. What is blessing on the other way? Blessing is an empowerment from God that will always bring prosperity and success and results of God in our life. Blessing is an empowerment from God that will always bring prosperity and success and results. Result of whom? Result of God in our life. It is an empowerment. What is that empowerment? That empowerment is to be fruitful, be multiplied, subdue the earth, replenish the world. That is our empowerment. That is what the Lord has blessed us with. So let us understand that. Okay, so now when we understand this, we very well know that when we are strong in our spirit, when we have a strong spirit, now come what may, whatever pressure the enemy tries to give us in our mind, come what may, anybody tries to talk to us, you know, maybe somebody, like for example, I told in the beginning that maybe somebody is cursing the child, maybe somebody is saying that you are of no use in the family, you are like, you know, a bad omen in the family, like whenever you are there is no work happening. So these all things are there. But if that child, if that person is strong in the Lord, is strong and firm in the Lord, okay, now that person will not take anything what the person opposite is saying, but always say, Lord, I am your righteousness. I am your righteousness. And thank you, Lord, that I am a blessing to the family. Now, what is that person doing? That person is going to use Romans 4:17. Because Romans 4:17 says, call for the things as though they are, as though they were not. So you call for those things. And now when the person speaks life, what does this person speak? Proverbs 18:21. Okay, the people are speaking death. But if that person is rooted in the word and speaks life and keeps on saying, no, Lord, I am a blessing to the family. I am the blessing in Christ Jesus. And when that person keeps repeating and keeps imagining and calls for those things, now when we follow the system, now that system brings results. That system brings results. And because of that system, when somebody knows the system, when somebody knows what has the Lord kept for us in the blessings, and the Lord has given us his authority, and what is that authority? Given us his likeness. What is that likeness? The authority is, I can speak to the mountain. Mark 11:23. I can speak to the mountain and tell that mountain to go and fall in the sea. That is my authority, what the Lord has given me. He has blessed me with that authority. And now when I speak to the mountain, I know when I know that I speak in the authority of my God. And nothing is going to harm me. Nothing is going to destroy whatever I want. What other thing has the Lord given me? The Lord has made me in his likeness and image. Means what? Now, when I make an imagination as the Lord has made, as he brought me and as he showed me, what did he show Abraham? What did he show him? He showed him the stars. Why did he show him the stars? He showed him the stars because Abraham said, I am lacking. He said, I am lacking. He said, how can you bless me? And why are you giving me so much of riches when I do not have even a child? And when he saw it is lack, what did the Lord do? The Lord said, come out of your tent. Come out of that small thinking of yours. Come out of it. Come out of that closed nature of yours and come and see what are my blessings for you. Come out. Come out of that closed doors and come out and see. And look at the top. Look at the sky. Count the stars. Those are the countless number of generations I have for you. Look at the sand. These are your generations today. Abraham is not there, but the word of God still stands. Because when we believe in the Lord Jesus, we are blessed with the blessings of Abraham. Galatians 3:19 speaks about it. So let us understand that. Let us know our blessings. We need to follow a system. We need to know our inheritance. We need to know what blessings have the Lord blessed us with. We need to know our authority in the tongue. So everywhere, we are blessed. And only the knowledge when we don't have, we think that we are under curse. We think that we are under law. We think that only if I do this, then I get that. If I only fast, then I get something else. So we are putting ourselves under a law. Yes, we need to fast. and please go for it. Whoever wants to fast should fast. Why? Don't make your fast limited. Never make your fast limited. Never keep your fast only for yourself. Never keep your fast only for your children. Never keep your fast only up till your household. Go. The Lord is an unlimited God. Fast for the entire world. If you're fasting for your children, fast for the entire, the children, the youth of the entire world. The devil may devour you and say, Ari, you are only one. And how can you fast for such a big creation? You can, because you are one in spirit with the Lord. You have the power of the Lord. You have the authority of the Lord. You stand one with Him. The Holy Spirit is in you. God Himself is in you. So we can do that. But if we are going to, say, no, if I fast, then I will get my results good. If I fast, then I will have that house. If I fast, don't do that. That is known as selfish. That's known as selfish fasting. Something what I want for me. I'm trying to do a barter system. But if we want to do something like that, go selfless. And say, Lord, yes, I'm looking this out for me. But at the same time, you are the Lord who have died for the entire creation. And they are all your children. They are all come from your bosom. And as I take up this, I take it up for the entire creation. If a husband and a wife is facing troubles, if a wife wants to, fast and pray or something like that, you know, something different, or say some extra prayers, do it for everyone. Pray for somebody else, because when you pray for somebody else, blessings come to you too. And in abundance, more than you expect. So we need to follow the system. When we follow the system, we actually get everything that the Lord has promised us. It is not only the promise, it is how much we believe in that promise. How much do we believe? Promises are there. The entire Bible is a promise. How much do I believe in the promise? So let us understand blessings and curse. When we do not have the knowledge of what is blessings, we think that we are under curse. So as we are learning this, let us go and give this same teaching. Let us tell somebody else about this. Let us show them the difference. What is the difference between a blessing? What is the difference between a curse? What is known as curse? What is known as blessings? And how can we save ourselves from that curse? By operating in the right words through our own tongue. By operating in the system of the unseen, by calling for things, by having faith that it is already ours, it has already come to pass. That is the blessings we are called for. We are given the blessings to speak with authority to the mountain. It is given to us. It's a gift given to us. So let's make ultimate use of these blessings, ultimate use. And as we heard, it takes guts to believe in Jesus. So let's show that guts. Let us not feel, oh, this is not working for me. No, it is working for me because my God has said that. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you, we praise you, and we love you. Thank you, Lord, for the abundant grace, blessings you have bestowed on us, for making us understand that we are so blessed, so blessed. Thank you, Lord, for these blessings that you have made us in your likeness, in your image. You have given us the power, the dominion, the authority. You have given us the gift of the fourth dimension, the imagination to call for things. You have just given us everything selflessly, Lord. You have not kept anything for yourself. You have just given us everything. Then, Lord, let us apply. And as we apply, we see that we are victorious in you. We thank you and we praise you for this blessing, O Lord Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for teaching us that there are two things in the Bible, and we belong to the blessings. And we are far away. We are never, never in that category where it is known as curse. And thank you, Holy Spirit, that we are using these blessings to bring other people into blessings, the ones who do not know that they are blessed. Thank you, Lord. We pray, make this prayer in the mighty and glorious name of Jesus. And all God's people said, amen, amen, and amen. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Amen.
Amen.